Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. We are going to talk about momentum and kinetic energy in collisions. In the previous video, there was an explosion, and now we are going to talk about collisions. We have two particles colliding. One of them we call it projectile, the other one we call it a target. And we can have one-dimensional collision, we can have two-dimensional collisions. And we assume that these collisions happen on a frictionless floor, so no external forces. During the collision, during the time of the collision, the forces are internal, and therefore there are no external forces, and therefore always in collisions linear momentum is conserved. Always linear momentum is conserved. Now, the kinetic energy, whether it is conserved or not, it has some special conditions to have conservation of kinetic energy. Okay, so we have what is called elastic collision, and we have inelastic collision. Okay, talk about collisions here. The word, most important word here is collision, and try to concentrate with me, my son. Talking about collisions, we have elastic and inelastic. Okay, in the elastic collision, here in the elastic, momentum. When I say momentum, I mean linear momentum. Please, we are talking about linear motion. Here we have, later we will see angular motion when we have angular momentum. But here, we're talking about linear momentum. So when I'm going to write momentum here, I mean the linear momentum. We're talking about straight line motion, okay? Momentum is conserved, okay? Conserved means momentum before equal momentum after. After what? After the collision. So we have a situation before collision and we have a situation after the collision. We say momentum conserved, and also kinetic energy is conserved. Is conserved, okay? Both of them conserve. Okay? Both of them are conserved in the elastic collision. But most of the collisions are not elastic in general, so you always have loss of energy during the collision. So kinetic energy is conserved. It means the kinetic energy before the collision and the kinetic energy after the collision are the same. Now we go to inelastic collision. Here the momentum is conserved. Okay, so you notice that momentum is always conserved, whether it is elastic or inelastic. So momentum is conserved just like this. Just like the elastic, but here kinetic energy is not conserved. And generally, it is lost. It's not conserved. And generally, it is lost as heat and sound energy. When the collision happens, you hear sound, there's heat between the two. So energy is kinetic energy is generally lost. Generally, it is lost. Here, energy is constant. Before and after, same value here. Here it is. It could be less. Kinetic energy after the collision is less than that before the collision. Okay. We have one special case here. It's called completely inelastic. Okay. I'm going to put it here. Under inelastic, we have completely inelastic. Here in the completely inelastic collision, the two objects, or the two bodies, stick together after the collision. After the collision. So it is when the problem says, when your problem says this is a completely inelastic collision, you should know that the two objects, before the collision, they are coming, they stick together and go with the same velocity, okay? So they have V final is the same for both objects, okay? They stick together and go as one object with one velocity. V final, okay? Velocity is the same for both objects. Okay, let's write the equation of conservation of linear momentum because it is the same for both. So what do you write? You say that a P initial. Okay, we have a situation where we have a mass m1, velocity v1. V1 initial and mass m2 with a smaller velocity v2 initial, and they are moving. This is before collision, okay? And after the collision, they are again moving, M1 and M2, okay, with different speed, velocity, sorry. I call them V1 final and V2 final, right? And they are still moving, in this case, to the right, okay? They are moving to the right with different velocities. This is after the collision, okay? After collision. So let's write the conservation. This is one-dimensional problem. It's called head-on collision. We call this a head-on collision, okay? Head-on. Because later we will see what is called a glancing collision. It's two-dimensional, okay? Now it's a head-on collision. So let's write, what is the momentum? It's one-dimensional, right? This is my x-axis, my positive x, right? I can have a particle M2 moving in this direction. Be careful. Huh? It's not always like this. Huh? But the formula that I'm going to write is true for whatever direction you put. Huh? So I'm going to write M1, V1 initial. That's the momentum of particle number 1 or body number 1. Plus M2, V2 initial. That's the momentum of the second particle. This is before. Okay, this is the initial. Means before, equal M1 V1 final plus M2 V2 final. Okay, so this is the equation of conservation of linear momentum. We have two objects and they are colliding and momentum is conserved. Whether the collision is elastic or inelastic, the momentum is always conserved. Eh? So we can write this equation for all type of collisions. Okay, now if the collision is elastic, then you have to write the conservation of kinetic energy. And that equation is like this. Half M1 V1 initial squared plus half M2 V2 initial squared, that's the kinetic energy before the collision, equal half M1 V1 final squared plus half M2 V2 final squared. You have to be very careful. This is a scalar equation. Eh? This one doesn't have direction. It's a scalar. Eh? Kinetic energy is a scalar. This equation, you write it only when you see a kinetic energy conserved, elastic collision only. But this equation is valid for both, elastic and inelastic. If it is completely inelastic, then I'm going to write the equation for completely inelastic now. For the completely elastic here, you write M1 V1 initial plus M2 V2 initial equal M1 plus M2 V final. That's the equation when you have a completely inelastic collision. Completely inelastic collision. I told you the two masses stick together and they have the same final velocity. So this is before a collision, after collision. So these are very important three equations that you need to worry about when solving problems related to collisions. Now let's do a simple example. It's not a simple example because this example actually has two different concepts. So it will be a review for you for the previous chapters, okay? It's called the ballistic pendulum. Okay? Ballistic pendulum. And this is a very important problem because it is used to determine the velocity or the speed of bullets. And there will be an experiment in the lab where you will use a ballistic pendulum. So this is a kind of introduction to that, okay? In the ballistic pendulum, you have an object here hanging, a block of wood or of mass M, hanging like this, and then you have a bullet coming with the velocity V, okay, of mass small m. Generally, the mass of the bullet is very small, okay? So the mass of the bullet, we put it 10 grams, and the mass of the block, 1 kilogram, okay? You can see the difference between the two. And so this bullet is going to come here, hit, and then at the moment it hits, this is before, right? Before the collision. At the time of the collision, the bullet is here. And be careful, the bullet is going to stick into the block. So what kind of collision we have? What is the collision here? It is called completely inelastic because they stick together here. See, they're sticking together. The mass m here and the mass m are together. This is just after the collision, just after the collision. But it will not stay like this. It will come here. Okay. So they are all together here. The mass with the small mass, and then they will come to a certain height here. It's called h. Maximum height, where the velocity will be zero at the maximum height, and you measure that height, and from that height and only that height and the masses you can find the speed of the bullet. Okay, so calculate, amazing isn't it, calculate the speed of the bullet, of the bullet. Very beautiful example and very useful for applications. Okay, all right. So let me give you 30 seconds to think about. Actually, there are two different concepts in this problem or in this example. Two different concepts: the concept of collision here, and another concept here, the concept of conservation of mechanical energy. Okay, all right. Let's start solving now. Okay. Let's start solving. Okay, so let's recapitulate here. We have a bullet with a speed velocity v. We have a block at rest. The bullet stick to the block. They will have a certain velocity here, v capital, and this velocity will help the block and the bullet reach a maximum height here, h, and I will give you that h, the height there. In this problem is 5 centimeters, okay? 5.0 centimeters. By measuring that height, you can find the velocity of the, or the speed of the bullet. Okay? But let's first of all work here. The collision. So we have first, so divide the problem into two cases. The first one is the collision. And what type of collision is it? Tell me what type of collision. It is completely inelastic collision. So we have mv, that's the momentum of what? Of the bullet, plus zero, the momentum of the block. This is before collision, equal m plus mv capital. Okay? That's the velocity of the block and the bullet just after the collision here. Okay? How many unknowns I have in this equation? I have two unknowns. I have V and V. And this is equation number one. Okay? So I need another equation to solve my problem. If you have two unknowns, you need two equations. If you have three unknowns, you need three equations, and so on. Okay? Now we go to point number two, which is conservation of mechanical energy. Okay? Of course, a mechanical energy is conserved here because the tension, of course, you have a force, the tension force, is normal to what? To the motion, and doesn't do any work. So you can write delta K plus delta U G equal to zero. There are no friction. We assume that frictionless. I mean, there are no air resistance. We assume that the air resistance is negligible. We don't have applied force. So the equation here is correct. So what is K in a final? K final is here with a zero velocity. So I'm going to put zero. Minus K initial is here. This is my initial, this is my final for case number two. This was my initial and this is my final for the collision. This is my initial and this is my final for the conservation of mechanical energy. So I'm going to add zero minus what? Minus half M plus M V capital, right? Squared. This is the kinetic energy here. The first one is the kinetic energy here, which is zero, because maximum height, and the maximum height, it will stop momentarily here and comes back. And when it reaches this point, we measure the height, okay? Plus mg delta y, right? Delta u is mg delta y. I take my y equal to zero here, okay? Y is equal to zero here. So what is mg delta y? will be mgh, right? Equal to 0. Oh, sorry. M plus M. I have to add, because they're together. M plus capital M. Okay? Small correction here. So I take this to the other side. Half M plus capital M V squared equal M plus capital M G H. This will go. And I'm looking for V capital. Once I get V capital, I put it here. I can find V of the bullet. Okay? Now, so V capital is what? Square root of what? 2 G H. If you put the numbers, 2 times 9.8 times 0.05, you get 1 meter per second. Approximately 0.98 is about 1 meter per second. Okay? Almost. Almost 1 meter per second. What do we do now? We take that V, this V here, we put it here in equation number 1 to find the V small. So V small, which is the speed of the bullet, is M plus M V capital over small m, okay? If you put the numbers there, 0.01, which is it 1.01, okay, times 1 here, the speed, velocity, speed of the both of them, over 0.01, it gives me 101 meter per second. That's the answer. This is the answer, okay? This is the speed of the bullet before it hits the block. And that's the answer to this problem, which is called the ballistic pendulum. Thank you.